You might have heard the phrase that Jesus died. And I'm not here to tell you that Jesus didn't die. No, that would be a lie. But allow me to suggest that Jesus died is an incomplete sentence. Plus, it's in the past tense. And yes, it's intense. Once upon a tree, Jesus died. That's history. But on day number 3, he rose again with victory. And because of what he did, we are free from paying the fee of eternal death because he paid the debt. And so Jesus was not just religious. King Jesus was genius, and I will say it until you get a little bit jealous, until you join us. No, I'm serious. He fed thousands who didn't have bread. I saw him bringing people back from the dead. He drove out demons from the demons bound and taught us how to walk on holy ground. He made lepers' skin like new. The storm dissipated when he told it to. Took jars of water, turned them into wine. The Savior even healed this heart of mine. And this one exceptional thing about the God of Genesis, that when you truly understand, you will not fail to burst into happiness. Jesus is proved to be the genius of Genesis. His profession then substantiates this hypothesis, because you see that when he meets any form of illness, he exercises his father's synthesis, and from broken pieces, he produces a living masterpiece. For example, watch this. In the beginning, the earth was without form and void, but lo and behold, by the power of his word, he made this world. So why don't we trust this astronomical God with our trash? Why do we think God is too harsh? And make no mistake, in the past, God has turned people into ash, but he knows that we're just slapdash, just dust. So he instructs us to simply trust in Jesus Christ. And Jesus makes it very clear. He didn't come for the righteous, he came for the sinners. He did not come for winners, he came for losers. His mission is one of recreation, to bring humanity back to the image of God, Imago Dei. But Jesus is not just a good designer, definitely not, because every manifestation of his creative power is also an expression of infinite love. Back to Genesis, the first thing that God creates is light. And the Bible then picks up on this metaphor that says God is light. And this shouldn't surprise us, because scientists just found out that light actually has a dual nature. It can be a wave or a particle, so it's not strange if the Bible puts forward that light has a spiritual dimension, meaning as well. But there's more to light than the visible naked eye can see. Science continues to tell us that light is made up of 3 rays. One originates, the other consummates, and the other illuminates. Why is this so? Because God made it so. Why did he make it so? Because he is so. If God is light, then he must have the properties of light. The most protruding to me, which is the 3-dimensionality of light. And exactly as hypothesized, the scriptures presents a God made of 3 individual persons, but one mind and character. So you have this Trinitas, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, 3-in-1, and love being the essential characteristic of God. This is the best place where it should be expressed. God is depicted as a community, and that confirms that he is love, because throughout eternity, the heart of God the Father has been poured towards the Son and the Spirit, and the heart of the Son to the Father and to the Spirit, and the heart of the Spirit to the Father and to the Son. Love, according to its truest definition, is unlimited. It is sprawling and cannot be bound by space, time, and matter. And so then, because of love, God creates human beings in his image. And his image means his 3-dimensionality, but most importantly, his character of love. So when God had created Adam for the first time in the history of creation, he sees that something is not good. After 5 days of pronouncing things good, something is not good. But what does good mean anyway? Well, on the first day, God created light and pronounced it good because it expressed his image. On the second day, God created the atmosphere and pronounced it good because it expressed his image. On the third day, God created vegetation and pronounced it good because it expressed his image. On the fourth day, God created sun, moon, stars and pronounced them good because they expressed his image. And on the fifth day, God created fish and birds and pronounced them good because they expressed his image. And on the sixth day, God creates beasts, and then suddenly something is not good. Adam on his own cannot fulfill the three-dimensionality of God and the love of God, and so God created Eve, with whom he can socialize with and love, fulfilling love, through whom Adam and Eve can have a child and thus be three. But in the garden of sin and shame, male and female, God had created them. But then that old serpent, through a newer serpent, deceived Eve. Eve confused Adam, ate the fruit, and the same Christmas Eve, the twosome had to leave. And I call it Christmas Eve because that night marked the beginning of a new birth. Jesus was to come and be born so that we can be born again into the image of God which we lost. And that is the genius of Genesis.